Hey, what's up, guys? What's up, BTY family? UMC family, Coach Bobby. It's Wednesday hump day. January 16th. Gonna check in really quick. Gotta take my son to basketball practice. Always doing something, trying to get these kids better than yesterday, right? So today I'm gonna talk about frustrations you guys have, especially women out there who might have about the comparison between how much weight you can lose versus how much weight your husband or boyfriend or male friends can lose. So I know many of you have faced this dilemma when you and your husband or you and your boyfriend go on a diet, right? Low carb, maybe just lower calorie, no fat, no sugar, no sugar especially, diet. And you get frustrated because your husband or boyfriend loses weight much, much faster than you. So I'm gonna help you guys understand exactly why that is, why it happens, in hopes that you will make some changes and understand some changes that you can't make that are inevitable because of our differences in our genders. But again, I'm trying to teach you guys the underlying principles and laws that govern what we do in health and fitness, and nutrition and exercise, so that you can make, number one, make informed decisions, and number two, hopefully you won't get as frustrated when things happen as they should happen, right? You don't get mad if you throw a ball in the air and it comes down. It's the laws of gravity. You don't get mad when you throw a ball against a wall and it creates a dent. That's a law of physics. So by the same token, I want you guys to understand and not get frustrated if you understand the laws of weight loss, right? The laws of weight loss between men and women. All right, so what happens when you typically go on a low carb or no carb or no sugar diet is your body runs out of available glucose, right? The availability of glucose is diminished, is decreased substantially. So you have three levels of energy supply for your body, right? You have immediate glucose that is in your bloodstream, right? You also have intermediate or short-term stored glucose as glycogen in your muscle and liver that your body can get to relatively quickly, especially via exercise. Then you have long-term storage of energy, and that's in fat cells, right? So you have bloodstream glucose, you have stored glucose as glycogen, and then you have long-term storage of energy in fat cells. So that's the order that your body tries to extract energy from your body to do whatever, to breathe, to walk, to live, to do all your bodily functions, and also to exercise and think and do the activities you do throughout the day. So when you stop giving your body a steady supply of energy via glucose, like most of us either have done or continue to do, right? You eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner that consist of high or at least moderate glucose. So when you go from giving your body a steady diet, a steady supply of glucose, it must then convert or go to the next step or the next layer of available energy, and that's stored glycogen, right? That glycogen, which is glucose stored in the body, is stored in your muscle and your liver. Now, obviously, males typically, or in general, have larger muscles, right? And so their capacity to store this intermediate or medium level or short-term level energy is greater, right? They have a larger capacity to store intermediate energy, right? Or short-term energy. Not immediate, right? So because of that, they can get to that intermediate layer of energy faster, and they have more of it than women do, all right? So they store more energy in their muscle and their liver than women do because they have larger muscles. The livers are relatively the same size, but the muscles obviously are bigger on men. So we store more intermediate energy in our body naturally. Right. So when you go through a diet and you reduce the amount of glucose you give your body regularly, it runs out more quickly. of that intermediate supply of glucose in the bloodstream. So it goes to the next level, the next layer of energy, which is your muscle. Men have more of that. So we can stay in that layer for longer, right? We have more of that layer of energy to extract from our body, right? Once that's gone, whenever it is, whether it's short term, whether it's long term, whether it's quick, whether it's, you know, fast, once that layer is gone, your body begins to extract energy from body fat, right? It begins to oxidize or burn body fat, right? Creating what is called ketones, right? Once that's done, your body puts the ketones in your bloodstream and your body can use that the same way it uses glucose. What's up, DP? So the reason men lose weight faster and they can keep up that rate of weight loss faster is because we have more muscles, right? So we store more glucose in our body. We store more glucose as glycogen in our body. So that second layer, which is not as fast as immediate glucose, like after you eat a donut or some bread, that's glucose immediately in your body, right? So it's not that fast, but it's right behind that, especially when you exercise. So we have more of that quicker, not super quick, but we have more of that quicker supply of energy than women do, right? So now when our body begins to convert, right, that glucose, that stored glucose as glycogen into energy, it has to pull it out of our muscle and our livers, right? It stores it with water, but our body must use three parts of water for every one part of glucose when it's stored as glycogen in our body. So when our bodies begin to extract that energy, it releases water. So if we have a lot of that intermediate supply, we can release that water and release that stored glycogen for a longer period of time. So we can lose more weight for more days than women can, right? If they stop eating, if you women stop eating glucose, right, and allow your body to tap into the reserves, the storage of glucose, that storage is minimal for most women. So that storage is gone quickly, right? If you fast or go no sugar, right? Either way, once you get to that next level of fat burning, that's slower, right? The problem is we can do that longer. We can store more glycogen, we as in men, and the water that's used to store, we can store more of that. And so that means we can release it for more time. So we can lose a pound or two a day for several days, whereas a woman, right, you women out there might lose a pound or two every few days and only last for a week, right? Because you don't have as much of that available, that intermediate source available to you. So that's part one of the equation, right? We have more, like for me, I can literally store 5, 6, 7, 8 pounds of glycogen in water in my body within 2 or 3 days, if not sooner. Right, I can also extract or get rid of 5, 6, 7, 8 pounds of stored glycogen in water within 2 or 3 days. Right, women, most women don't have the capacity to store that much glycogen in their body. Right, so men have more. So that's part one. Part two is because our bodies spend most of the day burning fuel outside of exercise. Right, so most of your day, even if you exercise regularly, most of your day is spent not exercising, right? Not deliberately burning fuel, right? Weight training or cardio, right? So for most of the day, your body has to rely upon metabolism, right, to burn fuel. That's why I talked to you guys about having your body be as effective at burning fuel between workouts as it is during workouts. That's why it's critical to begin a lean muscle building strategy so that your body can help you for all those hours that you can't run on a treadmill or can't get on a Stairmaster or can't work out, right? You need for your body to help you. So when you have more muscle, you have a high metabolism. Your body requires more fuel, more energy to maintain muscle, to repair muscle, to build muscle. Right. So when you have muscles, right, the 23 hours before workouts, I'm sorry, between workouts or the 2 days between workouts, the person who has more muscle is going to burn more fuel per second, more fuel per minute than a person who does not have as much muscle, right? So because men typically have more lean muscle mass than women, right? The average body fat percentage for men is lower than women. So we have more lean muscle mass. So our bodies have to expend more energy, right, while resting, while sleeping, while walking, while working, than women. We expend more of that, not only immediate glycogen, but also stored glycogen in our muscle and liver, right? So those first two layers, we can burn through them more quickly, typically, right, for a typical male and a typical female, number one. We also have more of that quicker to get to glycogen than most women. So women out there, you're confronted with two, drawbacks, right? Or two things that are at your disadvantage when it comes to weight loss, okay? Number one, again, we have lean muscle, right? Men have more lean muscle mass, so they burn through energy on average at a higher rate than women do, right? On average, some women are more lean and they burn more fuel per second. But as a generality, men have more muscle mass, so they burn energy at a higher rate, number one. Number two, that layer of energy availability to us, right? Again, the first layer is immediate glucose in our bloodstream if you've just eaten something that's carbohydrates. Layer two, right, is anything that our body stores for short-term intermediate usage. Right, those two layers, we have more of that layer, right? Those are quicker to get to than fat, right? So we can spend more time, more days burning through that layer, that intermediate layer that's stored in our liver and muscles. So while women, you might get frustrated because you lost 2 or 3 pounds or 4 pounds and it took you a week, your boyfriend or husband might lose a pound a day for 10 days, right? Doing the same exact strategies, low carbs or no sugar, whatever it is, as you're doing, right? So that's frustrating, right? But the good news is that once you get to the point where you have gotten rid of all of your body's stored glycogen, like that's the real goal. It's not weight loss, right? It's fat loss, right? The weight you're losing to that point is just watering and stored glycogen. So even though he may have lost more weight than you, right? And lost weight for a longer period of time than you did, if at the end of that, you're both rid of all your body's stored glycogen, you're both at the same point in terms of changing your body composition. You're both at the point where your body must begin to oxidize body fat. And that's the real key. That's the real key, is to change your body's composition, right? It's to keep or build lean muscle and rid your body of body fat, not weight, right? Weight, I get it, it's important because, I don't know, you just like seeing a number, right? But the weight itself is not critical. Your body composition is critical, right? How much lean muscle you have versus how much body fat you have. That's what all the health markers rely on, as far as, you know, all the disease rates, you know, the high blood pressure, the rate of heart attacks. All those things are based on the percentage of body fat you have on your body, not the weight, right? There are guys who are 240 pounds who are lean and healthy. There are people who are 120 pounds who are not, who have too much body fat and are unhealthy. So we need to watch, and I get it, we watch the weight, I get it. But we have to watch the weight as it relates to body composition, all right? So there's two things you can do, females, that will reduce your frustration, hopefully. Begin to build muscle, right? Begin to lift weights that challenge you. Right, begin to lift weights that you can't do more than 20 reps of. Right, put that pink dumbbell down. Don't be afraid to push yourself, to be a little sore, to grunt every now and then. Right, because that's going to give you an asset that no diet, no pill can replace, lean muscle. Right, that's your biggest asset, your biggest ally in this fight. against body fat, because you can't train enough often enough for enough hours to burn through the fuel that you eat. So you want your body to help you. You want your body to help you in the hours between workouts, right? So you want your body to burn as much fuel as you can make it in between workouts. And you only can do that via building lean muscle, all right? And number two, I want you guys to really begin to build your fitness level and your stamina and your strength, right? Because that's gonna give you the ability to train harder, to get rid of glycogen faster. So yes, you can stop eating sugar and carbohydrates, and you can go days and let your body burn through it. But if you build up your stamina and your fitness level, you can expedite that tremendously, right? If you are at a point where you understand what it takes to get your body rid of glycogen, and you're willing to go into the gym or on the track or whatever it is and put in the work, you can enjoy the weekend and still get rid of your glycogen in a couple days, the way I do, right? That takes time, but that's hope for you, because you can get to a point where you too can enjoy some pleasures like wine and pasta and bread and still have the ability to rid your body of that glycogen and get your body into a state of fat burning and not be frustrated because your husband can do it or your boyfriend can do it, what seems to be faster, okay? Remember, the weight loss that he goes through, for the most part, is no different than the weight loss you went through. It might be a bigger number, but at the end of the day, it's still the stored glycogen. So you can tell him that Coach Bobby said that his 10 pounds is really not much different than your 3 pounds, right? Because at the end of the day, you're both at a point now, when that rate of loss stops, you're both at a point where now you're burning body fat, and now is the critical juncture of where you want to be. You want to be at that point where your body has run out of glycogen and is now burning fat. So for him, it probably is 10 pounds. So in some ways, it's better for you because you get to fat burning with fewer pounds of loss, right? You have to lose 3 pounds before your body begins to burn fat, right? He has to lose 8 pounds, whatever it is. The number's bigger. So yeah, he lost 8 pounds, but he had to lose 8 pounds before he could burn body fat, all right? So don't get frustrated, women. I know, ladies, that it can be frustrating because he's bragging about it, and you know he's running around the house with his towel on, and showing you pictures of the scale. But again, it's all relative, right? It's all relative. So keep in mind, you know, in the future, the way you can begin to make that process easier is build some lean muscle, right? Increase your conditioning and your fitness levels, so that you too can begin to have periods where you have some fun, I get it, but also have periods where you're able to get back into the gym and knock out that glycogen quickly and get your body primed and ready to burn fat for a few days. All right, so I'll go over those details again, over and over again, how we do things, how I do things. And again, I eat, people who know me know, I eat carbohydrates. I don't believe in no sugar. I don't believe in no carbs. I don't believe in going full ketogenic diet. I have principles of all those things, but I do it in a way where I can live my life. I can enjoy time with my kids. I can have pizza when I want, or I can have popcorn, or I can have bread. And I can do it in a way where I'm not training in the gym every day, right? I train 4 days a week, if that. Usually three, and then a half one with my class on Saturdays. But I train hard, I get rid of glycogen, and I make sure that I watch my G-tank. I watch the levels of my glycogen in my body to make sure I don't build or store body fat, and make sure that I'm always in position to get rid of glycogen and let my body burn fat. All right, so hang in there, women. Hope this was helpful. If you have questions about anything, or you need me to talk to your husband to stop teasing you or your boyfriend, send me a message, and I'll reach out to him and help him understand that it's basically the same thing. We're just trying to get to the same goal. We just do it differently and at different paces. All right, guys, so have a great night. I take my son to practice, and I will talk to you guys soon. Take care now. Bye-bye.